Welcome back to Africa 54. I'm Esther Githu Ewart in Washington. As Zimbabwe's healthcare system collapses with the economy and medical worker strikes, some women are being forced to rely on midwives and give birth in unsanitary conditions, which experts say exposes the mother and child to infections. Columbus Mavunga reports from Harare.
Zimbabwe clinics often suspend operations since medical workers in September went on strike to push for better wages. Pregnant women have been forced to get help from midwives to deliver their babies, too often with poor sanitation.
I ask each expecting mother to bring a razor blade, a pin for the baby's navel, and cotton. Nothing untoward has happened. It's an easy task after the baby is delivered. I ask the mother to go into my bedroom to rest while I take care of the next one.
74-year-old Zinoro Gwenya says she has already delivered about 250 babies in November, an average of 13 per day. While she says all mothers and babies survived, the lack of sanitation means a higher risk of infection. It is also a symptom of the ailing state of healthcare in the country, says the Zimbabwe Hospital Doctors Association.
It's a sad situation that we find ourselves in, whereby women are now giving birth in a place that's not sterile, that doesn't even meet the minimum World Health Organization's requirements for a facility that is suits for delivery of babies. So it's just a reflection of the current healthcare system in our nation at the moment, which is on the verge of a collapse. So people seeking alternative health methods, we call upon the responsible authorities to act on the situation with the agents that it deserves.
Zimbabwe's doctors and nurses want the government to also provide modern equipment to clinics and hospitals which have crumbled along with the economy. Authorities say they are aware of the healthcare problems and are working to address the issues.
We are very much on top of the situation within the health sector and within the education sector. We are working closely with the Ministry of Health to make sure that the adequate and sustainable resources as required by the doctors are provided.
Meanwhile, expectant mothers in Zimbabwe may have no choice but to give birth in unsanitary conditions that put their babies and themselves at risk. Columbus Mavunga for VOA News, Harare.